he is, MBE, the crown king of UK soul, it's Omar. There's nothing like this. Do you feel like you're continuously improving?
Yeah, yeah. You know, when I wrote There's Nothing Like This, yeah. I made a cassette tape. You're too young to know
I
that.
Know cassette tapes, come on.
It was a 90 minute cassette tape and I just basically repeated the song over and over again.
Yeah.
And I was like, well, if you can listen to 45 minutes of that and not get bored, then there might be something in it. And I've kind of stuck to that. Sensation has its flow.
Oral communication, don't you know? So your song with Maya Andrade, Deja Vu, it's a bit more of a sort of swing sound, so it's kind of more her vibe than yours. How did that come about? What's it like when you're sort of collaborating with someone? What's the process like? Can it be quite difficult? Like, who takes charge?
Oh, well, me, of course. No, but with with Myra, it was a very organic process, you know?
Yeah.
We met up in Paris, just hanging out, and I remember she was cooking dinner one evening,
oh, really?
As I was playing the music, and then we just kind of like got the vibe together, and then you know we came up with this beautiful piece of music. You know, it really does depend on the circumstance and the individuals that I'm working with. 'Cause you are the best of me. How can I be sure this is the right
time? You've been known before to fail so miserably. You've worked with so many amazing people, even Stevie Wonder. That's incredible. Do you ever worry with collaborations that there might be creative differences ever?
I mean, sometimes, you know, I've worked with people and it hasn't kind of worked out straight away.
Yeah.
You know, believe it or not, when I first started working with Stevie,
yeah.
We were working on a certain tune, but I was really kind of feeling the vibe. You
okay.
know? And I don't think he was feeling it either
until
that's when I got a phone call the next day. He said, yo, I've got another idea, let's go in the studio. And that's the song that became Feeding You. To be alive,
so the next generation of soul singers are emerging. What do you think it is that's going to define them from your generation?
I don't know, but you know, listening to a lot of stuff that I see on YouTube,
these
kids are coming, it's like they're coming out of the womb talented. You know what I mean? Because you're getting the kids like, as young as 6, 7 playing bass, guitar, keys, drums, but coming out playing really, really amazing well. Everyone should take time to develop their sound. The look has to be a certain thing. So they're all very important factors that you need to think about and consider before you even step into the arena. You know, I've been lucky enough to have started out quite a long time ago.
Yeah.
And so I've established myself, I've established my sound.
Mm-hmm.
So I think I've made a success of that. Not as rich as Stormzy, but you know what I mean? I'm not doing too badly.
That, Omar, thank you so much. It's been a pleasure.
Bless you.